The Boy Who Cried Wolf. There was once a young shepherd boy whose job it was to look after the flock. Day after day, he climbed up the hillside with the sheep. He would watch over them as they grazed, and all the while he would be dreaming about the excitement of the big city. The peace and quiet of the countryside was not for him. He needed more life, more adventure, more emotion. One day, the boy decided that he could no longer tolerate the long, dull days. He needed some fun, and he knew just what he was going to do. He climbed up the hill with the flock as usual, but this time, once he reached the top, he shouted out at the top of his voice, "Wolf! Wolf! There's a wolf trying to eat the sheep!" He took his horn out from his satchel and blew it as hard as he could. Upon hearing the boy's cries and the sound of the horn, the villagers all came running. There was a great commotion as they all jostled to reach the top and save the sheep.
Where's
the wolf? They asked once they arrived, puffing and panting.
Wolf?
There is no wolf, laughed the boy. I tricked you. This job is so boring. I needed to do something to amuse myself, and you should have seen the look of panic on your faces as you came running, you fools. And the boy rolled about laughing. The villagers were angry.
Don't cry wolf again, shouted one of the men, and the others nodded in agreement.
They turned their backs furiously on the boy and began to make their way down the hill, back to their homes and businesses. The next day, the boy made the trip up the hill once again. Oh, how he was bored of this routine. Day in, day out, he traipsed up the mountain with the sheep and watched over them. Nothing exciting ever happened. Nothing ever changed. So he decided to trick the villagers once more. After all, yesterday had been the most fun he had had in a long time. He opened his mouth and at the top of his voice cried out, "Wolf! Wolf!" And he blew on his horn as loudly as he could. The villagers heard the boy's cries and came running up the hillside. When they arrived at the top and saw that there was no wolf, they were livid. "Save your cries for when there really is something wrong," they shouted. "Don't cry, wolf, if there is no wolf. We won't believe you a third time." With that, they turned and made their way down the hill. The boy was too busy chuckling to himself to take any notice of their warning, and the rest of the day passed by uneventfully. The following day, the boy was once again watching over the sheep. It was a warm, sunny day, and he had positioned himself under a tree to get some shade. He tried to stop himself from dozing. Just then, out of the corner of his eye, he caught sight of a black shape moving towards the flock. The boy sat up sharply and looked more closely. There was no doubt about it. It was a wolf. Immediately he began to shout at the top of his voice, "Wolf! Wolf! Come quickly! There's a wolf!" And he sounded his horn. Nobody came. He continued to cry out, "Wolf! Wolf!" But still no villagers came running. The boy was beside himself. He didn't know what to do. There was nothing he could do. He watched in horror as the wolf scattered the sheep far and wide across the hills. Evening came, and the boy made his way slowly down the hill, alone, bringing no sheep with him. "What's the matter?" asked the villagers. "Where are our sheep?" "I shouted," answered the boy meekly. "A wolf came and scattered the sheep. I blew my horn and I shouted, but none of you came." One of the villagers put his arm around the boy, who by now was sobbing loudly. "How could we be sure that you were telling the truth?" he asked the boy. "You had already tricked us twice in 2 days,
How were we to know that you weren't tricking us once again? Nobody believes a liar, even when he's telling the truth." The boy stopped sobbing and wiped away his tears. He looked at the villagers.
I've learnt my lesson. I'll never cry wolf again," he promised.
And he never did.
Thank you.